Hi Groover, Chris here from mtbtips.com with mountain bike race tip number 20, the race face. Now, poker players have a poker face, and as a mountain bike racer, you should have a race face as well. Just like in poker, your race face can give you a psychological advantage over your competitors at times and really hide what you're thinking. And it can give you a couple more advantages too, but I'll get to those in a minute. But first, just imagine you're in a really tough 60 kilometre mountain bike race and you're about 50 kilometres into it. And you've got this guy, he's been sitting on your back wheel for the last 20 miles. And you think he's sitting back there struggling, and all of a sudden, he just breezes past you like it was no effort at all. And you look over at him, and the expression on his face is one of pure pleasure and freshness. And you look at the rest of him, and he's looking pretty fresh. He's got a good posture on his bike. He's not rocking from side to side. You're going up a climb, mind you, so it's a bit of hard effort. And he's looking way better than how you're feeling. And, you know, how would that make you feel? You'd look over at him and you'd be thinking, geez, he's looking pretty fresh. There's no way I'm going to be able to stick with him. But maybe he's just got his race face on. And maybe if you get your race face, then that could be you overtaking and accelerating away from him next time. So find it hard to think of a race face? Well, think of something that is a good memory, something, maybe it's a joke or something that brings a smile to your face that you can pop into your head during the race at any time. Now mine, well, I've got a couple. The first one is no chain, no chain baby. And it's a little saying I picked up from George Hincapie years ago. He uses it when he races. And it's over the years, it's been a bit of a personal joke between a mountain biking mate and me. And yeah, when I pop that in my head, it just helps me feel a bit stronger and a bit fresher. And just the mention of it to myself in my head just makes me go. And to me, it means that you know, I'm feeling so good that I'm pedaling so effortlessly that I don't even need a chain to do it. It doesn't even feel like there's a chain on the bike. So yeah, boom, no chain baby makes me go. The other one is Christmas pudding. Sometimes I just start thinking a bit about Christmas pudding, say, right, if I get past this guy, I'll get some Christmas pudding, just to trick myself, just to shake me out of maybe the hard effort I'm putting in and help me beam on the outside and look good on the bike. And that might just be enough to make the person that I'm passing think, whew, gee whiz, he's looking a bit fresh, I'm not going to bother chasing him. Now, your race face, it could be anything, like I say, it could be like a memory or a joke or something like that that you remember each time that works. And, you know, for the girls, it might be thinking about a massive shoe shop or something like that, I don't know. But whatever it is, make sure it makes you smile, make sure it works in the race. So where do you use a race face? Well, plenty of places. You can use a race face on a start line, you can use a race face when you're pacing one of your competitors, or when you're overtaking or accelerating away from them, of course. Even when you're in transition, you're waiting for your next lap, you're in a four-man team for a 12-hour race and you've got other competitors lining up beside you. But the number one thing is, yeah, make sure it makes you smile, make sure it works. And also don't forget the rest of your body as well. Make sure you've got a good posture on the bike, that you look strong, that you look fresh, and that those legs look good, like they've got plenty of power there. And you know, that might be enough in the right situation or the right overtaking maneuver to make your competitors look over at you and think, geez, that guy looks fresh. I don't think I'm going to bother chasing him. And there you go, you get the gap. And on top of that effect that your race face can have over your competitors, it can give you two more psychological advantages as well. Number one, mentally, it can help you when you think about your race face, when you think about that chant or that memory, it can help you think and stay fresh and focused on the bike. And it just can be one of those extra things that helps you stay focused, especially when the going gets tough in a race. And number two, because you know what a race face is now, your competitor's race face isn't going to demoralize you anymore when you look over and see it. It's not going to put a dent in your confidence when someone comes up beside you and they look so fresh. Because now that you know what a race face is, you'll be looking over at them and you'll be thinking, he's looking pretty good, but I'm not buying. I bet he's got his race face on. And the next thing, you'll be thinking, right, no chain, baby, it's on.